Hey guys, this is a bit different of a video than I normally do. It's not a video game. It's a review of something else. Well, for the last about 8 months, I've been working. That's why there's been less videos. And where have I been working? I've been working at fucking Wendy's. That's where I've been working. Yeah, a shitty fast food job is where I've been working for the last almost 8 months. And I just wanted to give a little insight and little bit of a review on, well, working at Wendy's for almost 8 months. So here we go. I'm Jonathan, I'm 18, I no longer work at Wendy's. At least I could say that now. A little bit of backstory of working at Wendy's, it's just for the simple reason I was still in high school, and I just wanted to get some money. You know, the sad story of the poor high school kid who wants to buy video games or whatever. It doesn't really matter. Like, I just wanted money. That was pretty much the simple fact. I mean, I had shit to pay for also, like my prom and Disneyland and video games and all that amazing stuff. So I was like, oh, okay, I'll just work some fast food job. And, oh, look, there's Wendy's. I mean, I'll just talk to the manager and get hired or whatever. So I went down there and talked to the manager and she was just like, oh, okay, you can work here at Wendy's. Here's an application, fill it out. You know, this is easy stuff. Like, and then she's like, you're hired, okay, whatever. You could just start, you can be just cashier or whatever. Just deal with the people, you know. Just standard cashier crap for a fast food job. Now, when I started in February, it was, early March. It was pretty simple. I mean, like, I worked like nothing, and it was just a pretty simple gig. I mean, I'd go there for the weekend and maybe once or twice in the middle of the week. It was pretty easy. I mean, I don't think nobody really talked to me. I didn't talk to anybody else there except the janitor. He was the only other white person there. Everyone was Spanish or somewhere in that area. And really, like, I didn't speak Spanish, so I wasn't really able to talk to many people there, but it was okay. I mean, it was just the first job, and that's what I was thinking. I was like, oh, it's not that bad. You know, it's not that bad. And then April rolled up, and I was like, oh, you know, I still work at Wendy's. High school's way more important. I mean, I'm making a little bit of money on the side. I mean, it was more than what YouTube's getting me, that's for sure. And it was about May-ish, and I was working, you know, like 15 hours, like nothing. I was working like nothing. It was perfect. There barely any working at Wendy's, like, a bit of money. There was tons of cashiers there who were there to aid me, help me, and they were just nice. Like, there was probably, I could guess, 10 or so cashiers there at Wendy's along with me. And so I barely even worked. All the better cashiers were there. And then, about May, the super awesome manager that everyone loved, who got me hired, she told me she was leaving. And I was just like, are you, what? Like, you're leaving? And she said, yeah, I'm leaving. And unfortunately, really, like, a majority of the cashiers, they loved her. And they said, I'm not going to work here if she's not working here. And when that manager gave her two-week notice, the awesome one that got me hired, about 8 cashiers also gave their two-week notice. And it was at this time that Wendy's really set in on me. My other managers, my main manager of the building, who's still the main manager, she's been the main manager for like 20 years or whatever, I don't know. And she was like, Jonathan, all the other cashiers have left, and you're not that experienced. You've been working maybe like 10 hours a week or whatever. You're the main cashier now. We need you to work every day, and we need you to work at least 4 hours every day. And I was like, oh, okay, that's not that bad. I mean, oh yeah, it was bad. It was really bad. Like, you want to talk about someone taking advantage of you? They totally took advantage of me, and it took all this time for me to realize it. I mean, back then, I was like, oh, I'm making money, I got nothing else to do, I'm just playing video games and watch porn or whatever, but they totally just, my schedule went from a 10-hour schedule to a 35-hour schedule to like a 38-hour schedule in the course of a month. And when I say that there was nobody to help me most of the time, I mean, there was nobody to help me at Wendy's. Like, I did the drive-thru, I never did the front. They never let me do the front. They said I was too ugly, evil, whatever, piece of shit. I almost never did the front at Wendy's. That's one thing I can say that they never had me do. And I would be, basically, if you can't guess what I was doing as a cashier, I was like in the drive-thru, I'd take the orders, I'd collect the money, I'd do the drinks, put the food together. I wouldn't make the food. That's something that they never had me do. They told me I was horrible at making the food. I don't really care. I mean, it's making food. Who cares? And I really honestly wish I got to make the food. I'll explain why later, but I never got to make food. I just did money, orders, soda, putting the orders together, and that's all I did. And it 9 times out of 10, it was in the drive-thru. And I was never in the front. The front was just way too nice for me, I guess. They put me in the drive-thru. They were like, you're good at the drive-thru. We'll do the front. And I was like, oh, okay. That's not that bad, I guess. But when everyone left, it used to be that I was in the drive-thru. I would just take the orders or maybe just collect the money, and that was it. They wouldn't have me do anything else. Now, when everyone left, they said, Jonathan, you're going to take the orders, you're going to collect the money, you're going to pass the food out, you're going to do the sodas, you're going to put the order together, and you're going to have to do it all at once. So I went from doing one thing to 5 things. Now, you might go, oh, it's just a fucking fast food restaurant. Well, trust me, when you have people, like, when you have to do 5 things at once, it's just really, it's not really hard work, it's just a lot of work. And when you have assholes on the fucking drive-thru and you're trying to, like, get fries and shit, like, it's just a douche move. Like, why would my manager do that to me? And it's because there was nobody to help me. And that's the bottom line of this whole small story of this. There was nobody to help me after all the cashiers left. It was literally Jonathan, drive-thru, Jonathan, do everything, fucking do everything that the managers do. I was on like a manager working level. I worked as much as the managers, and I did as much shit as the managers. But working there, I mean, I was getting money, and it was a job, but it was just really, really just annoying, to be honest. So at this point, I know what you're thinking. You're like, why are you even talking about this? Why are you talking about your stupid stories about Wendy's? Well, this isn't my review to tell you to work at Wendy's or not work at Wendy's or McDonald's or wherever it is. I mean, people have to do stuff they're not proud of. Everyone in my family worked at a fast food place first, like even my extended family. So it was my turn to work in some shitty fast food place. But the point of the story is, like, Wendy's only got worse. Trust me, it only got worse from there. They hired a couple more people. It wasn't just me doing everything. There was a bit more help. There was a new manager. She helped me. And I didn't have to do 5 things. I only had to do like 3 things, which was pretty okay, I guess. I mean, compared to what I was doing before. I mean, during the summer, it got really bad. Like, I was working 40, 41, 42 hours a week. And that wasn't even 18 yet. That wasn't even legal. But Wendy's doesn't give a fuck. Like, I can say that they absolutely give no shits about the law. I was closing the drive-thru at like 1 in the morning. I wasn't even 18 yet. And they were having me work over 40 hours, which is, it's just completely illegal if you're under 18. But I didn't say anything. I was like, oh, I'm getting money. It's fine. I mean, like, I bought a super nice-ass computer with a bunch of my money. But deep inside, like, I felt really just honestly depressed and really just... That's when, honestly, the biggest thing about Wendy's really came out about me. The thing about it was it just pretty much dominated my life, like, for 3 or 4 months. Like, Wendy's just dominated my life. It was, I wake up, I go to Wendy's, I go to sleep. It was pretty much that every day for a while. In fact, when I was in high school, right after the manager left, I went 13 days without a day off. 13 days. What the fuck? But enough about that. It just dominated my life, and I was working a ton of hours. But the biggest thing, by far, is the customers. Holy shit, people are so fucking stupid. And that's my main issue of working at a fast food place. People are so motherfucking stupid. I can't even begin to describe how retarded a ton of people are. And I just want to fucking hurt them. I was so mad during the summer, like, at everyone. I just wanted to hurt everyone. I wanted to punch them, kill them, fuck them up. It was just ridiculous. People are so stupid at Wendy's, like, who just go to fast food. Like, I'm not saying you, but you'd be surprised how many stupid-ass people there were. There'd be people trying to sell me drugs, That was a lot, especially when I worked at night. Working at night was just where all the real assholes were. I had this retard who asked, what's the difference between the 4-piece nuggets and the 6-piece nugget? Can you fucking count, you dumbass bitch? And I had people throw their soda at me, people throw their water at me. I watched one of my friends who worked there, he got fries thrown at him. What the fuck is wrong with people? A lot of people trying to sell me weed, actually. I don't know. Those are just a couple off the top of my head. People asking if the fucking Baconator is bacon. Assholes who want to start their order over after I take it. Like, please, stop. I mean, and then there was just the fact of my managers just always calling me, Jonathan, can you come in? There's nobody. And I was like, oh, okay. And the worst part is if I'd ignore them, they'd call me like 10 times, leave 8 voicemails, text me, and I'd be like, oh my god, just leave me alone. It's my fucking day off. But no, I would go in for like 4 hours because I just wouldn't let them, they wouldn't fuck off. And so I'd eventually just go in and work at a fast food place for 8 months now. But it's all over now. And so how do I conclude this amazing story of working at Wendy's? This isn't even a fucking review. This is just a story of me working at Wendy's. Well, here's how I conclude it. I'm not saying don't work there. Don't work at a fast food place. I mean, if you need money, you need money. I'm not ever going to judge you because you work at a fast food place. I mean, I will always be so nice to people working at fast food now because I understand the hardships they go through. The fucking assholes that... It's just ridiculous how much shit they gotta do, and if any assholes are like, oh, they're taking forever, well, you know, they probably got shit to do. I mean, like, they told me, they're like, oh, you're taking fucking forever in the window, and I'm like, you know what, fuck you, dude. Like, I'm trying to put your food together, I'm trying to get your sodas, take other orders, and trying to collect your money, and you're telling me I'm too slow? Well, fuck you. That's what I gotta say. Fuck you. And... a lot of things I could say, don't ever eat at Wendy's, that's for sure. The fries I could say are good. The nuggets are good. Don't ever, and I mean don't ever eat the fucking chili. The chili is the most nastiest shit in the world. Like, just don't ever eat the chili. That shit is nasty. Don't ever eat, like, the Frosties either. The Frosties, I can hear the picture. They're just not good, the Frosties. What they have you do at night is they have you get all the Frosty out of the machine and they have you put it in the fridge and it melts in there in the fridge and you're like, oh, it's fridge. Well, it's still like liquidy and shit. It's all nasty. And then they have you put it back in the fucking machine the next morning. What the fuck? They don't want to waste food. Oh yeah, the patty meat's just nasty. So don't eat the chili. Don't eat the ice cream. I don't know about the potatoes. Like, I had some retard ask if potatoes have meat in them. Fucking stupid piece of shit. And really, like, nowadays, since I don't work at Wendy's anymore, I could say I'm gonna try to make a few more videos. So this has just been a little insight on Wendy's. I mean, like, I can say there's been just a bunch. I know this video has been all over the place. It's not really a review. What's my rating on working at Wendy's? 0 out of 10. I hate Wendy's. But that's besides the point. Everyone there was luckily everyone who worked there nowadays was very understanding and completely understood why I was angry. They agreed with me on everything. My managers were almost always on my side. My coworkers were almost always on my side. There are a couple fucking retards that work there though. I can say that anyone could get a job here and anyone can get fired here, but they never fired like anybody. They never fired anybody because besides me, there was like, it was them and me and that was it. And the other people, they never even showed up. It was just me. Every time, it was just me until about August when all these good people started working there and they're all great. But when I started, I remember I was just like, you people are retarded, you're stupid as fuck, and I hate you. What are my final thoughts on working at Wendy's? Well, my final thoughts of working at Wendy's or any fast food place is if you need money, it's easy. Not easy, but it's easy money. It's really shit pay. I mean, for all the work you're doing, you put your heart and soul into this shit, and you're getting like what, $500 a week, $600 a week. And I mean, I did get a raise. I even got offered to be a manager, but I was like, no. I kind of have a life. I'm in college. I got more important shit to worry about. I mean, when I gave that 2-week notice, I was like, oh, thank you. I just praised everyone. I mean, I said goodbye to everyone. And was just so happy that I left. I mean, I know it's really hard for people to get out of fast food, but I got out. I can tell you it's pretty bad. I mean, if you need money, it's money. Don't ever say your job is bad when you work there, because then you're just gonna hate it. I never told myself I hated it. I mean, I knew it was bad, but I never told myself I hated it until I quit. Now I can say, I'm gone now. I'm done with Wendy's. My last day was a couple days ago. On my last day, I was a complete asshole to everyone. I don't care. I mean, it's my last day. There were spiders all over this dude's drink. I gave him the drink anyway. I don't give a shit. This has been a really weird-ass video. I mean, I've never made a video like this. But here it is. My thoughts on Wendy's, I mean, 0 out of 10. Wendy's is okay. I mean, the food's okay. Not the chili or the frosty, but it's okay. I mean, I'm gonna try to make more videos now. I have a much better job. Much better. There's no customers. There's no retards. Yeah, the end.